I'm guessing there's no cable.
By the time an exorcist is called to assess a possible possession, the parish priest would have ensured that all psychiatric explanations had been exhausted. He would have questioned the possessed himself and forwarded his assessment onto his bishop. With the bishop's permission, an exorcist is then summoned to determine possession. Often early signs of a possession are subtle. Social withdrawal, apathy, persistent tremor in a limb. It can go unnoticed until the victim is deep within the demonic spirit's grasp. This was taken at an exorcism in Turin. The woman survived without food or water for 8 weeks before the demon released her. This man's jaw spontaneously dislocated while being read the Lord's Prayer. He made no physical contact with any object, nor was he met with any physical force. Demons are the devil's foot soldiers, often operating in groups, much like a squadron, infesting their victims. It is the job of an exorcist to determine the number of possessing demons and their names, something the demons protect with great ferocity. And when the exorcist has a name, he can then begin to assert control over the entity and cast it out. Who have we here?
Michael Kovac.
Sorry?
Michael Kovac.
Oh, yes. The American.
Yeah, sorry I'm late.
Yes, I prefer punctuality to apologies. Welcome, sit down. The most identifiable sign of a possession is the negative reaction to sacred objects. Crucifixes. Holy water. The man that you have just heard was reacting to a crucifix placed on his head.
Excuse me, Father?
Yes?
What if he was suffering from the delusion that he's possessed? Wouldn't he react in the same way?
Admittedly, it's very easy to confuse psychotic illness with possession. It's up to the exorcist to discern the difference.
So, how do you do that?
Well, there are many ways. For example, paranoid schizophrenics are not aware that they're deluded.
Neither are the possessed while they're being possessed, are they?
But people who are possessed have periods of lucidity, that's my point.
So do schizophrenics.
One can't suddenly manifest abilities simply because one is deluded. The man on this tape is German. How does he spontaneously speak Russian?
How could a boy in a village in Africa, found 400 miles from his home, claim that he was abducted by aliens? It's just as unlikely. But we're willing to call him crazy and your German man not, because he believes in aliens, not God.
We're not here to scrutinize religion with science. The object of this course is to view phenomena through the lens of faith.
So which do you believe in? Aliens or God?
The jury's out in both.
Interesting perspective for a priest.
I'm not a priest. Yet.
So you're having a final fling with atheism?
Well, I guess it's more like an ex-girlfriend. It keeps coming around.
Angelina, comincia la proiezione in biblioteca. Vieni con noi?
Arrivo.